Hi guys, Chris here back. As you can see with the Honor Note 10 now, there's been a lot of requests for me to cover this and I finally gave in and decided to check it out and got one of these docks here for it. So the Type-C port can output HDMI like other mobile phones. Now there's the Asus Zenfone 3 Max that I tested out about a year and a half ago that was one of the first ones to allow us to do that. But that was just a simple HDMI out. So with this mobile phone, you can get what is called the desktop mode. So it's acting like a desktop, gives you access to your applications. You can even plug in things like a mouse and keyboard. So what you need to get if you're interested in this is this right here. So this is the Huawei MateDock 2 that also works for various other Huawei tech. Now I tried out my other Type-C hubs with HDMI out and they didn't work. So there's obviously something in this little dock here that it detects as a Huawei dock, and then the phone will go into that desktop mode and output HDMI signal. So the dock, you can see, looks just like any other Type-C dock with HDMI out, but there are of course a couple of little differences with this one. So at the top here we have USB 3, I think that is actually. So that'll work on other tech that support USB 3. And then on the outside here, we've got VGA out, and then we have HDMI out. Now this is HDMI out up to 4K with other devices from Huawei, but not with this particular phone here. This phone is only going to output 1080p. You've got right here Type-C in for charging the phone as well. And the build of it, well, it's all made out of plastic. So in order to get the dock to work, you must have power plugged into it. It won't work without it. So if you plug in an HDMI cable, you plug in the dock but no power, nothing happens. But as soon as you plug it in with power, it pops up right here. So these are the options you get. So it will act as a touchpad. So this can be the touchpad. You can move around the cursor on the screen with this, but I highly recommend plugging in a mouse. Now there's various other little options. It actually comes up like a little help menu first when you first go through it, just telling you how to use it. And right here you can swap between the display output. So right now you can see here easy projection. So that is telling you that it's just in the desktop mode. So when I tap this, it then goes into phone mode. And it is basically cloning what you see on the screen is now being displayed on my TV. I'm running it right now, what you're looking at, through a 4K TV. This is an HDR TV, but there's no HDR and there's no 4K. So the resolution maxes out at 1080p. We get these options here too for if you right click. So I've got my Logitech mouse and receiver plugged in for the keyboard that I've got as well. And you can see you can change the screen size, but this is not actually changing the resolution. It's just really changing the scaling. So I keep that on full screen. So very familiar layout here. It looks a lot like a Windows desktop or Linux or something similar. And very common layout of everything too as well. So everything's familiar. So right down here you can actually see the status of your signal. You've got your notification center here. That's got everything that you'd get, of course, on the phone, but just pulls it up there on the side. So it's quite well down there. Our remaining battery percent, it is plugged in and charging at the moment. The time, and then you do have your menu keys there right in the corner if you need them. Now, the sound output can also be selected to go through the mobile or your TV in this case. So this is the 4K TV that I'm running. So I'll just quickly show you the performance here. This is Chrome with my website, and I'm scrolling. You can see this is actually really good, very fast. It's running kind of like an Atom, really, the performance, or somewhere between an Atom and perhaps a Core i3 or a Core M, the kind of performance you'd expect here. So everything's loading in quick, images are fine, and the scrolling is smooth here. Now I'm using the mouse for scrolling at the moment, but you can actually use the touchpad, which I showed you before, so you can use that, but it's just not as fast, of course, as using a mouse. So that's taking a little while to load in for some reason. I think it's where I've got the actual phone located. So I've put it in a drawer because it's so easy to drop this phone being all shiny and I don't have the case on it. Now you can even load in other apps. So these are the default apps you've got. So you've got your emails, you've even got Notepad here, and I'll just see if I can quickly type here with the keyboard, which hopefully I've got battery in. It's one of those solar powered ones here. Okay, you can see there. So you can use it like a typical desktop. Now I don't imagine or see a lot of people actually taking advantage of this, but it could be handy to show things like movie files or videos you've recorded, your gallery perhaps. So I just actually opened that up too. So here's the gallery, that performance you can see, really smooth, very fast. There's some of the photos that I was taking for my review and some new night shots that I was also taking as well the other day. So you can bring those up, full screen them and show them off to people. You just need to of course have the Huawei the MateDock 2 here that I've got and in using there. So you can open up, of course, YouTube as well. Bring that up. Various different apps. And the performance, as I mentioned, seems pretty good. I've even got PUBG running here. Now, we can't control it properly. You need, obviously, you need the keyboard configured for this. Maybe there's an app out there that will allow us to do this. But at the moment, it's even really hard just to get around. So with a mouse, I can click on some things. I'll click start, see if this is going to load in. And so I've got that going in the background and a Chrome here too. Bring that up. You can minimize things. I'm not too sure if this one we can actually... No, it doesn't look like I can run that one in a window for some reason. It wants to be full screen or nothing. It just depends on the apps that support. So here we are on PUBG. It's actually loaded in. That performance seems all right. But, there we go. Actually, if I hold down the mouse pointer, I am actually able to move around here with the typical arrow keys on a keyboard. So that is great. So maybe the game obviously added support for that. A few little stutters just then. And just show you here too as well that I have it on the HDR option and ultra frame rate settings. So this is the fastest really that you can use with this phone. Is right click going to be my scope? No. And fire, to fire the weapon, I have no idea. So we're going to have to, actually looks like I'm going to have to put the mouse pointer over the fire button to fire. So that's going to be a little bit tricky. The controls, you're going to have to configure, find a way to get around this. So when I want to fire, if I aim down here at this truck, try and aim at the wheel, and then I'm going to have to move the mouse cursor over and then fire. So yeah, that's really tricky. And the same goes for the zoom. Zoom, I have to use the mouse for that. And you can see, there we go. That, at least, seems to be okay frame rate-wise, but just that, yeah, those controls are really fiddly. But great to see this, and I can see if I can, there we go, get that into a smaller screen now. And you could even have, at the same time, in the background there, be reading up on something while the game's loading, or if you died and you're just spectating, that is all, of course, possible to you. So as you can see, you can open actually up a lot of stuff on the desktop here. So I've got Twitter open, emails, gallery, Chrome, and everything else is listed under third-party apps here, you can see. So the rest of the apps I've got, most of these, you can run them. Netflix as well is possible too. Prime Video even, if you wanted to stream using that. And some of those games, you will have control problems. So it's not really for gaming, the desktop mode. Just another thing also to point out that the display will eventually time out. So it's completely off now. So you don't have to worry about any screen burn on the display when you're in desktop mode. If you're going to always be using that and be worried that it's constantly displaying some sort of icon on the screen that could burn in. No, no problems with that there whatsoever. So the phone is still charging, gaining charge at the same time here. So it's great to see this option. I would like to see more phones that actually allow us to get the display out. So that was just a preview there of what you can do once you pair it up with the Huawei MateDock 2 is what it's called. There could actually be another dock or two from Huawei that actually will work with this phone here. Thanks a lot for watching, and if you haven't, check out my other videos on the Huawei Honor Note 10.